Okay, I'm so excited to have a new picture book out. It's been a while since I've introduced new characters in a picture book, and you know, my career began as a picture book author and illustrator, and regardless of where my creative life takes me, be it with graphic novels or chapter books, the picture book will always be a part of what I do. I'll always go back to the picture book. And my new picture book is called Peanut Butter and Jellyfish, and it's about a seahorse named Peanut Butter and a jellyfish named Jellyfish, and they're best friends, and they spend their days swimming in the ocean and playing, but they have to contend with this crab named Krabby, who just barks these insults at them constantly, and he's a terrible character. He's not nice. The book began as all of my books do, with a sketch. I just, for one day, for whatever reason, I opened up my sketchbook and I started drawing this jellyfish, and he got a best friend who was a seahorse. So the story just naturally developed, and it became the story about these two friends who were bullied by a crab, and when that crab was in trouble and in danger, the heroes of the story had to decide if they were going to help him or not. And you know, I didn't sit down at my sketchbook and say, I'm going to write a story that's about anti-bullying and helping people regardless of your history with them. I just wanted to write a fun story about a seahorse and a jellyfish, and ultimately and accidentally, I wrote an anti-bullying book. To create the art for this book, you know, I wanted the art for this book to look very different from all of my previous picture books. So what I did was I created black line work for the characters and the environment. But then what I would do is I would create these abstract acrylic paintings. And I was playing with color, I was playing with texture, I was loose, I was carefree, because this wasn't the finished product, it was a small part of the finished product. So then I would take all of that black line work and all of those paintings, and I would scan them into my computer, and in Photoshop I would take the black line work and place the characters where I needed them to be, and I used that as a template where I would then bring in the acrylic paintings and collage everything together. So the book ultimately is a digital collage of acrylic paintings. Now my daughter Zoe, at the time she was 4, she had just turned 4 and when I was working on the art for this book, and as she does, she spends a lot of time with me in the studio. She'd always just, right off the bat, she'd want to get on the iPad. So I instituted a rule that she needed to have at least 20 minutes of creative time. And as it went, those 20 minutes became 40 minutes, became an hour and a half. Well, one day, and perhaps I was just, you know, I was being lazy, or I was just too intent on creating the art that I needed to get done at my desk. She needed a piece of paper. Well, I just grabbed one of those abstract acrylic paintings that had already been scanned into my computer, and I'm not precious with them, so I said, here, take these, you can let's reuse this paper. And she painted on top of my paintings, and to reward her for that creative effort, we then scanned that artwork into the computer together. And in a few spots, I used her artwork to make up the collages. So if you look really closely at the bottom of the fishing boat, you'll see her little 4-year-old fingerprints. Well, I hope that everybody enjoys reading Peanut Butter and Jellyfish as much as I enjoyed inventing the characters and writing the story and creating the artwork for the book.